Hello children, today is the 30th of April, let's start our classwork. So today we will speak how do teens from different countries spend their free time. Мы сегодня поговорим с вами по этой теме, как подростки в различных странах проводят их свободное время. Смотрите сюда, у вас в учебнике этого раздела нет, потому что это по старому учебнику сделано, у меня нового учебника нет, в сети его, в принципе, нет тоже доступного, поэтому я делала по старому учебнику, вы с учебником не работаете, работаем только с презентацией. So, let's start. Давайте начнем. So, what's this? Look at these photos and tell me, what this match? These phrases, these words with this picture. So, to earn, this is, да, зарабатывать. To go window shopping, да, ходить по магазинам и смотреть просто витрины. И to go camping, ходить в походы. So, today we'll speak about time spending of different teens, да, from different countries. So, watch the videos about the scouts. What do Cub Scouts do? What do Cub Scouts do? Answer this question, please. Watch the video and answer it. So, what do they do? Что же они делают? So, what did you know from this video? That is a very interesting organization. They learn different, as you see, values that last a lifetime. They spend their time in different activities. They learn how to go fishing, go swimming. They learn first aid, первой помощи. They have different performances, различные выступления, да? So it's very interesting, I think, organization. So, okay, next. The next organization, the Girl and Boy Brigade. So, for over 125 years, the Girls and Boys Brigade has provided a welcoming place for children and youths who need a helping hand. We are dedicated to providing quality education, recreation, and life skill activity. Our consistent and practical approach helps the enrolled children and youth become better equipped to deal positively with life's challenges. The Girls and Boys Brigade is registered as a public benevolent institution charity, a public company limited by guarantee, managed by a board of directors, a deducible gift recipient, the holder of fundraising authority from the Office of Liquid Gaming and Raising, funded by donations and investment income, no government funding. So, the next organization, Boy and Girl Brigade. Yes, the Boy and Girl Boys Brigade is interdenominational Christian youth organization convinced by William Alexander Smith to combine real and fun activities, да, какие-то объединить навыки и развлечения, спрямованные на христианское, да, какие-то христианские ценности. Following its inception in Glasgow in 1883, the BBC quickly spread across the United Kingdom, это по Великобритании они распространились и стали worldwide organization, всемирной организацией by the early 1890s. As of 2003, there were 500,000 boy brigade members in 60 countries. Да? Там у нас было для мальчиков и девочек, это только для мальчиков, да, такие бригады. Дальше. 4-H clubs. Что же это такое? Да? In the United States is a youth organization administered by the National Institution of Food and Agriculture of the United States Department of Agriculture with the mission of engaging youth to reach their fullest potential while advancing the field of youth development. Да? Приобщить молодежь, чтобы достигнуть своего наиполнейшего потенциала. Да? И развиваться. The name represents four personal development areas of focus for this organization. На что направлены, да, четыре области. Это head, голова, heart, сердце, hands, руки, and health, здоровье. The organization, вот почему, да, 4H называется. Head, heart, hands, and health. The organization has over 6.5 million members in the United States from age 5 to 21 in approximately 90,000 clubs. The goal, да, of 4-H is to develop citizenship, гражданский долг, leadership, лидерство, responsibility, ответственность, life skill, навыки, жизненные навыки of youth, да, молодежи, through experimental learning programs and a positive youth development approach. Through typical thought of an agricultural-focused organization as a result of its history, 4G today focuses on citizenship, health, living, science, engineering, and technology programs. Today, 4H and related programs exist in over 80 countries around the world. The organization and administration varies from country to country. Each of these programs operates independently but cooperatively through international exchanges, global education programs, and communication. The 4H motto is to make the best better. Сделать лучше лучшим. While its slogan is learning, learn by doing. Учись, что-то делай, да? Sometimes written as a learn to do by doing. Okay, why 4-H? Let's watch the video about this organization.
It's really fun, and you don't just—it's not—it's just not the meetings. It's just you can go to camp, and camp is probably the best thing to do in summer.
I just like all the energy and being together with all the other tribes.
There's a lot of fun things. You play sports. You can go swimming. There's council circle, tribal meetings. Everything's fun. I like it all.
It's a week that the kids get to learn not just funny songs, but also great, important life lessons.
A lot of fun, and you get to interact with kids, and it's just a lot of fun. You get to make new friends.
There's no other, you can't get a bond like this anywhere else other than 4-H. Like you meet people that you might not have any common interests with other than 4-H, but you can be friends with them outside of 4-H and have still be fun.
I keep coming back to camp because the family aspect of 4-H camp, it's just an experience of a lifetime. There's so many great friendships that you can make and so many just great life skills that are built here at camp. It's just a great place to spend a week of your summer and see all the people that you'd love to see.
And
Okay, so you see that they have a very great fun here. Say they learn how to communicate with others. They have a lot of friends here, so I think it's a good organization. So next, Boy Clubs of America. Boys and Girls Clubs of America is a national organization of local chapters which provide after-school programs for young people. The organization, which holds a congressional charter under Title 36 of the United States Code, has its headquarters in Atlanta, with regional offices in Chicago, Dallas, Atlanta, New York City, and Los Angeles. BGCA is tax-exempt and partially funded by the federal government. Да, спонсируется кем? Тоже. Другая. Для занятия после школы. Для молодых ребят. So, children enjoy playing and watching different sports. So, their favorite sports are cricket, that's for teens in Great Britain, and rugby for teens in the USA. Let's watch some videos about this sport. So, let's watch about cricket. Kansas Cricket Association. It is in the USA. This is cricket. So?
Welcome to This Is Cricket. In this program, we'll be taking you through the elements of one of the greatest games in the world, played by people in over 120 countries around the globe. Cricket is played between two teams, normally with 11 players aside. One team, Team A, will bat first and try to score as many runs as possible, while the second team, Team B, will bowl and field to make it as hard as possible for the batting team to score. The team then swap over, so Team B will bat to try and beat the score set by Team A, who will bowl and field. Adults, young people and children play cricket all around the world, in the street, on the beach, in the local park. Now let's have a look at the main aspects of playing the game. The aim of batting is to score runs. The batter also has to try to stop the ball hitting his wicket and getting him out. The bowler is also trying to make it as difficult as possible for the batter to score runs. Fielding is the job of the bowler's teammates. Fielders try to stop the batter scoring by stopping the ball as quickly as possible when it has been hit and throwing it back to either the bowler or the wicketkeeper. Fielders can also get the batter out by catching the ball. If the batter hits the ball, the fielder catches it before it bounces, and the batter is out. The wicketkeeper is a specialist fielder who crouches behind the wicket at the opposite end to the bowler. The wicketkeeper is there to stop the ball if the batter misses it, and to catch the batter out. Five key elements of cricket. As you can see, it's all very simple and should always be fun.
Okay, I hope that you like watching this video. So, tell me, would you like to play cricket if we had a chance to play it in our country? I think you would. So, the next sport, we will watch the rules of playing rugby. It's very American kind of sport. So, let's watch this video.
This game requires players to be graceful and gutsy. Hi, I'm Rebecca Brayton, and welcome to WatchMojo.com. And today we'll be learning how to play rugby.
This is the tough question, the million-dollar question. Give us a brief overview of the sport. Like, what's the aim of the game?
The idea is to score a try. It's a little bit like a touchdown in football, except you have to touch the ball down with pressure in the end zone. So the idea is basically to score as many points as possible.
How is the team broken down?
So the team is broken down into two sections. You have the forwards and the backs. The forwards are the eight guys in front, typically a little bit bigger. They kind of do a little bit more of the grunt work and a little bit less of the finesse stuff. And the backs are the last seven guys on the team, which tend to be a little bit more fast, a little bit, I would say, more skilled in terms of ball handling and kicking.
Tell us about the field.
The field is about 100 meters long. It's a little bit bigger than a football field. The lines are quite different, though. You have the two sidelines, two end lines, then you have a 5-meter line on each side, 22 center and a 40. So it's a little bit more broken down than a regular football or soccer field is. But yeah, that's the basic structure of the field.
How is the game played? Like, what are the rules?
Rugby, it's a complicated sport because there's a variety of different rules. Basically, you can't pass the ball on the forwards. Anytime there is a knock-on where you attempt to catch the ball but you drop it, what happens is you have a scrum where the eight forwards on each side pack down and the ball is fed into the middle and they battle out to see who can win the ball. When the ball goes into touch outside of the field of play, you have what's called a line-out. And so you can have anywhere from two to seven people in each line-out. And you can test the ball with the hooker being the guy throwing the ball into the line-out between the two teams. I mean, that's the really basic rules. There's obviously a variety more, but it's extremely complicated in that, you know, there's still some that I forget after however long I've been playing.
What are some important terms that we might need to know before we learn how to play?
Well, knock on, that would be attempting to catch the ball and knocking it on. A scrum is where the two eight forwards come together and they pack down. A restart, self-explanatory, after a try to score, you have a restart at center where the other team kicks the ball. A ruck is where a tackle is made at the point of the tackle. And there's two or more players from each team who come together and try to contest the ball. So that's a pretty important aspect because it tends to happen quite often. Generally speaking, those are, you know, for the beginners, kind of what you have to look for and what you have to listen for in the game.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Okay, I think you like watching this video. So I think rugby is a very aggressive sport. So choose between this one, which of these sports would you like to play, cricket or rugby? I think cricket is more interesting than rugby. So it's my opinion, not yours. Okay, next. So let's watch the video about camping in England. Many teens like going camping. So what do they do during camping? Let's watch.
My name is Jonathan Knight. I'm the author of Cool Camping England and editor of the Cool Camping Guidebook series. Camping's my passion, and when you come to a place like this, you can see why it's become just so popular over the last few years. With great views, great scenery, and car alarms going off every 2 minutes. It's perfect. This is Yulee's farm on the Jurassic Coast of Dorset. For 11 months of the year, it is just a farm with cattle and sheep and a few free-range hens. But for a month of the year, every August, they open it up to campers to come and take over their fields. Sun setting over there, fantastic view out to the ocean, the smell of campfires and people out enjoying the countryside there. I mean, it's just about getting back to nature and really connecting with the countryside and getting away from all the stresses and strains of the modern life. I think it's something to do with going back to our kind of primeval way we used to live our lives. When everything was much simpler, you know, just cooking stuff on a campfire. Sitting out, watching the sunset. And I think that's what people like these days. It gives them an opportunity to escape from their busy, modern, stressful life.
You can see, yes, the man that has told her that it's an opportunity to escape from busy life. So I think it's very good if we had a chance to see such a beautiful landscape. Okay, let's go to our book, but you don't open it. Вы не открываете, потому что у меня, я еще раз говорю, учебник старый, поэтому пришлось вот как-то так поработать. So, most school children from different countries have free time every day. Do children from Great Britain, America and Australia do similar activities after school? Read and answer the questions. So, let's read together. In Great Britain, most children spend their time at home watching TV or doing chores about the house, or they may listen to music or read. Many children have hobbies. They are great collectors. They collect stamps or postcards or stickers or favorite footballers or pop stars. Young people hang out in streets, in parks, visit town centers, and go window shopping. Мы с вами говорили, что это такое. Many young people use some of their spare time to earn money by working in shops at weekends, delivering newspapers, helping in the yard, or car washing for people in their community. Children are also involved in different clubs and organizations. As we watch the video, they go to scouts, boys and girls brigades. Children enjoy playing and watching different sports: football, rugby, cricket, swimming, horse riding, tennis, and many other games. So, what hobbies do children enjoy? So, in Great Britain, they enjoy what hobbies? collecting. Go window shopping, maybe some. Some teenagers like to earn on money by working in shops and weekends. They play in different sports. What sports? They play in for football, rugby, cricket, swimming, horse riding, tennis, and many other games. What do children do to earn money? They earn money by working in shops at weekends, delivering newspapers, helping in the yard, or car washing. So, what clubs, organization are most big children involved into? They involve into the scouts, boys and girls brigades. Mm-hmm. So text number two, let's read it, about the USA. So children in the USA have a lot of interest. Both boys and girls play many of the same games. They swim, play baseball and basketball, go boating and camping. Youth organizations like the Boy Scouts, the Girl Scouts, and the Boy Clubs of America involve children in different activities. After school, children take part in activities of different clubs. They join photography, music, art, STEM, collection, theater, and other clubs. Often girls have bands, choirs, and sport for boys and girls. In farm areas, children learn to work together in 4-H club. Children have part-time jobs after school hours. They earn money by delivering newspaper or help to take care of elderly people in nursing homes. During the summer holidays, children go to camps where they have lots of activities and learn different skills. Let's try to answer this question. What hobbies enjoy? So they enjoy playing sport, go boating, camping. Yes, they like photography, music, art, STEM, collecting, theater, and other clubs. So, what sport do they like? They like baseball, basketball, да, boating. Ну, camping — это не спорт. Следующее, что у нас там. What do children do to earn money? They earn money by delivering newspapers or help to take care of elderly people in nursing homes. Это приюты, nursing homes. Они помогают ухаживать за пожилыми в приютах. Далее. Вопрос. What clubs organization are most children involved into? They are involved into 4-H club, Boy Scouts, Girl Scouts, and Boy Clubs of America. Now we've read about this organization. And let's read about Australia. How do children in Australia spend their free time? In Australia, sports are an important part of many children's life, with cricket, football, soccer, and swimming being the most popular. Most children take part in after-school sport during this year. Most girls choose netball, and boys often choose rugby or cricket. Children prefer to spend a lot of time chatting online with their friends or hanging out at the beach. After school, many children also do different chores about the house, or they may earn money by working at the local supermarket or fast food restaurant. Thousands of Australian children join the Scouts and Girl Guides clubs where they learn different skills. So what hobbies? Playing sport. What else? Going to the beach, hanging out with friends, chatting online with friends. Okay, and what sport do they do? They do cricket, football, swimming, netball, rugby. Okay, what do they do to earn money? They earn money by working at a local supermarket or fast food restaurant. What clubs? They are scouts, the girl guides, and that's all. Yes? So here you can see short extract from these three texts. You may read it. And now let's go to your home task and I tell you what you must do. You should write this material. What I like doing and what I don't like doing in my free time. Что я люблю и не люблю делать в свое свободное время. Ваша задача – дополнить предложение, начало этих предложений о себе. То, что мне действительно нравится, это I'm keen on, да, фраза у нас была, I'm also fond of, схожие, I'm mad about, вообще, да, то есть с ума схожу, ненавижу, не люблю, я думаю, что это пустая трата времени. Что я делаю летом, теплую погоду, дождливую, и когда зимний, теплый, да, холодный зимний день, что я делаю? То есть оставить предложение, дополнить этот текст. Сколько у вас получится, ну, посмотрите сами. То есть все вот эти пункты должны быть. So, see you next week. Goodbye. Have a good holidays. Goodbye.